You probably know some fish are dwindling in numbers, so it matters what type of seafood you choose to eat. But did you know it's not just which fish you eat that matters? How your fish is caught is important too. Different fishing methods are used to catch different species, and some methods come with a side of environmental harm. Like long lines, they stretch up to 150 kilometers and can inadvertently hook or entangle seabirds, turtles, and marine mammals. Each year, an estimated 8,000 albatrosses die this way. Then there's trawling, where a cone-shaped net is dragged through the water at varying depths, scooping up fish of all sizes. Trawling along the seafloor causes damage and uplifts sediment that clogs filter feeders. Up on the surface, purse seines encircle schools of fish. They're selective, but not if used with fish aggregating devices. These devices increase bycatch of sharks, turtles, and rays. Set nets form a wall that entangles fish. The mesh can be big enough to let undersized fish through, but they also catch sharks, seals, dolphins, and penguins. They're a major hazard for our endangered species. Thankfully, technology is also helping the industry to become more environmentally friendly. For example, pingers on set nets deter marine mammals. And there are fishing methods that cause less harm. Trawling might be annoying in the comments section, but in the sea, it's a low impact way to fish. Lines with lures are towed slowly through the water, and any non-target species can be quickly unhooked. There's also the classic pole and line, one at a time method, which is low impact with little bycatch. So how can you tell if the fish you want to eat was caught in a sustainable or harmful way? Suppliers don't have to display this information, but you can ask them where and how their seafood was caught, or you can check out Forest and Bird's Best Fish Guide app.